Before starting Nestaway, I ran another startup called BridgeTV, which didn't do quite well. And I'm here to tell you that failures are usually not fatal. When you're planning to start up again, you may find this conversation useful.
Amar, your first venture was BridgeTV. Could you tell us about how you came about starting that?
I come from a rural background and I figured this out also that the digital divide that exists between the urban India and the rural India is going to be real. And if I could build some technologies and some solutions around how do we take the content that is available on internet to people back in rural India where internet doesn't reach, maybe on television.
When did you realize that it's time that things were not going right?
One of the things that I noticed when I was trying BridgeTV is that the first product that we tried called iExam, which is the exam on television, was good, but it didn't scale. Television as a distribution channel provides massive scale. So we kept trying 2-3 products on top. The joke is this, we made more money in awards than in revenue.
But you spent so much of your time on the startup and you devoted so much of your hard work. Was it tough giving that up after so many years?
It actually put most of my beliefs into test, and sometimes tough times test you really well. So it actually made me a better entrepreneur and better individual. I don't have any better memories of it, honestly.
So after BridgeTV ended, you jumped headlong into Nestaway.
Yeah.
You did not take a break. Was the seed of Nestaway already there when you were shutting down BridgeTV?
Yeah, I think that there is always an overlap between what you want to wind up and what you want to start again. I had done, or me and my co-founders put together, had about 3 to 6 months of easy overlap to think through, to know. Because see, one of the things that all of us were convinced is that we're not done yet. So we wanted to give our best shot. We are relatively young than we are today.
Do you think a break would have helped you if you had taken a break between the two startups?
I was always clear. I just want to try hard. Quitting is never something that I want to identify myself with. The thing about it is that when you're chasing meaning and impact in your life or in your career, you're always in a time zone when we want to do more. And a break does not add, in my opinion, to the decision quality, because in the back of your mind, there's always this process that runs and says, hey, are you doing enough? Are you doing right?
Did you feel like you were losing out on time?
I just think that the rate at which technologies are changing, the rate at which the world is moving ahead, the fungibility in mind and the ability to learn and cope up with so many changing things around you is a must. And it is just a matter of age. You know, when you are young, your views are open, you're less gentle, you have less things to think about. And as you age, sometimes life catches up, sometimes responsibility catches up, sometimes the tenacity of mind in dealing with new things goes down, because you're already filled with so much of information, so much of experiences. And these experiences could be very contrasting to the what's happening in the world. So you waste time in that mental tussle, hey, this is right, or what I know is right, and all that stuff. So I guess, building a company now, I would imagine, needs you to have a very open mind and very high degree of learnability. And it's just easier when you're young. I mean, the body, the biology helps you. So I started again with the view that if I don't start now, I'm not chasing my dreams now, with every passing year, it's going to be a tad difficult.
Some of your team moved from your previous venture to your new one. Do you think that helped in staying positive and, you know, made it easier to start up again?
Validation is always a great thing to have. The fact that BridgeTV didn't work out tested all of us. And when we repeated with the same team again, testament to the fact that we always trusted each other quite a lot. And failure, lack of failure, success, they're somewhat less useful in the entire scheme of things.
Since all of you had common history in the form of BridgeTV, it's easier to be frank and be open with your opinions. And, you know, if you're repeating this, any mistake, then it's easier to call that out because you have the same team.
I imagine that we don't second guess each other's intent at all. Of course, there are differences of opinion, there are differences of work styles. And having all of that, we pretty much know that we are all chasing the same common goal in our own unique ways.
So as you mentioned that you come from a rural background, and for them, they would not understand you know, how a startup works, what entrepreneurship is. So was it difficult convincing them that you're not taking a job, but you're choosing to run a company, failing at it, and then trying to run another company?
So two things worked in my favor. I was always successful in the minds of my parents and my spouse, that he will always try his best and he perhaps knows what's best. The fact that they don't get what I do just makes it a tad easier. So they know pretty much that he must be doing the right thing. And okay, maybe we'll just see it in course of time. It also brings a sense of responsibility that I must make better use of my time.
Your previous startup, Risk TV, it had investor backing. So did they have any say when you decided to shut shop?
Not really. I think they pretty much knew that the guys at Risk TV tried their level best. And maybe sometimes you're ahead of the time curve and or, you know, the technology becomes irrelevant and a bunch of things in general goes wrong. And I think the genuinity lies in letting people chase their dreams.
So all success to Nestaway, but if the chance comes up, would you ever want to go back to a job?
Yeah, for sure. If my job allows me to create impact and add meaning to life, and I'm excited about the kind of guys that I'm going to work with, and my if the need for my learning is met, I would love to work for somebody. See, the question is, what am I going to do with my time? That's the question that I continuously keep asking myself.